In this video, we will take a closer look at the characteristics and presentation of tension type headaches. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Headaches can manifest on their own, but are also a very common symptom in neck pain patients, as more than 60% of patients with a primary neck pain complaint report having concordant episodes of headache. Therefore, it is essential to find out what kind of headache the patient is suffering from. To start off, let's differentiate between primary and secondary types of headaches. But what does this mean? Simply put, primary headaches are a disease themselves, whereas in secondary headaches, the headache is a symptom of another condition. So, primary headaches would be migraines, tension-type headaches, cluster headaches, and something called medication overdose headaches. Secondary type headaches are headaches caused by tumors, hemorrhage, other trauma, TMJ dysfunction, or by disorders in the cervical region. Now let's take a closer look at tension type headaches, which belong in the category of primary type headaches. Tension type headaches have a mean 1-year prevalence of 48.6% around the world, with women being equally as often affected as men in an age range between 20 to 40 years old. In order for a headache to qualify as tension type headache, it has to fulfill certain criteria. Tension type headaches can vary from infrequent episodic, frequent episodic to chronic, as seen in this table. While the frequency and duration differ, patients in all three categories need to report at least two of the following four characteristics. Number one, the headache is bilateral. Number two, it has a pressing or tightening quality but not pulsating. Number three, the intensity is mild to moderate, so a patient will usually still be able to complete ADLs. As number four, the headache is not aggravated by routine physical activity, such as walking or climbing stairs. Also, there is one, no nausea or vomiting, and two, no more than one of photophobia or phonophobia, which is sensitivity to light and sounds respectively. Tools you can use to assess the impact of a headache on your patient are the HIT-6 questionnaire, which you can find in the video description. Also note that it can be difficult for a patient to answer all of the questions on duration, intensity, and characteristics of their headache during your assessment. Therefore, asking them to complete a headache diary can help in the assessment and then appropriate management of the headache, and you should be aware that there can be an overlap between multiple types of headaches at the same time. Okay, in the intro I mentioned that headaches are quite often associated with neck pain, so be sure to click on the playlist right next to me, which discusses the neck pain guideline by the KNGF from the year 2017. Please check the links in the video description to learn about ways how you can support us in running this channel. Follow us on other social media pages where we post on a daily basis. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new here. And as usual, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.